Coy Deason's family. Coy. Lee and Eli's family. Ain't Lee and Eli? Dalton Deason's family. Coy Deason's family. I reckon it's all over.
Ben Deason.
Huh? Oh, you're Ben Deason's family, I forgot about that.
And George Deason.
When Todd and they were from there.
That's what I was trying to remember.
You got a whole bunch of them.
Sure got it down there from here. Probably a lot of people didn't know who people was, so they asked me, said, asked me who the family members were.
Four ways you save and give your testimony and then what you know about Mount Tabor. Was you saved at Mount Tabor or where was you saved at?
Here.
Embry.
But he joined here.
Joined here.
Okay.
What year was that?
Don't worry, that's kind of bad for you. That's a threat for you.
Been married 60 years ago. We've been married 62 years. We wasn't married then.
It's been about 64.
I think I was 23 years old when I think it was.
About 2 years
before. Yeah.
So we're married 31 and 29.
Well, can you remember some of the preachers at Mount Tabor?
Way back.
Way back.
I can see him, but I can't tell you their names.
He can tell you his name, maybe.
I think we're too long to ask us very many questions, but the Garys used to sing here.
Where's Gary? He used to sing here, lead singing.
Who was an organ player?
I don't remember that. Probably didn't at that time.
I remember Capshaw, he had a revival with you.
No, Capshaw didn't. That was Curtinsville.
I thought that was him.
No. What's your one?
What would it mean?
I don't know which one you're thinking about.
Well, do you remember who the pastor was when you joined here?
No, I can't remember his name.
Brother Elwood Marks was pastor here for several years. We remember him pointing out because we came.
He came in 37.
He was an old man then.
You mean the man that was here then?
Yeah.
They had a Jackie Goodman that I never even know.
I believe that's who it was.
Had a Cooper.
Rode a horse up here all the time.
Cooper. They had a Thornton Powell that was a pastor sometime back in those days. Mm-hmm.
I don't remember him.
I don't either, but now Cooper, I think I remember.
But you think that Edwin was the one that was here when you joined the church?
Who?
Goodman.
Goodman, you think, was
the one?
I don't know.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. See, we dated about 3.5 years before marriage. And we came up here quite often because they had their services once a month and Curtinsville would have them more often. So we usually try to come here once a month through the summer. Mm-hmm. And we were dating, and then until we joined Pleasant View, we joined that in, I guess, when she was a baby, that had been about 38. So we haven't come, of course, much in the last few years, but as long as he was a member here, we kind of all things were good. We used to come up in the, my mother was a member of Tabor Church, and even when we were growing up, well, every, during the revival, during the summer, you know, Mama would have a wagon load, and we'd come up on a hay wagon. Well, she was a member here with her curtains in. Why don't you tell some tales about your daddy? Days.
Yeah, but a long time.
Remember here? Oh, we're prepared to do it, I guess.
Yes.
Do you remember any of the people that worked on it? The church that was built here, do you remember your daddy talking about who they were?
No, I can't remember. I
was building this building.
Yeah, boy, I can't remember nothing.
I know something about that.
See, they moved here in 1908. From Mount
1908.
This is the third place it's been.
That's before my dad. I was born in 12. So, you probably don't remember anything about that. You were
here since she was born, then, wasn't it?
Dad was born in 5.
Oh, a place I'm telling.
You wouldn't remember much.
I was 23 years old.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This place.
This is moved here before you were born. When you were 3 or something.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, I knew it was someone I remembered.
When you was a young boy, what'd you do when you come to church? I mean, did you take any part in the church or? Do anything?
Yeah, I was in the choir, went Sunday school class, whatever.
And they had the singing voice all the time, so.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Good. How about that's after Bert Carey had the singing here, and then he
did. He wouldn't got the star. Should have kept it up.
No,
did Miss Ollie French ever play the organ?
Ollie. Did Jane Ollie ever play the organ?
Oh. Some of those thought she did.
I don't know.
One time.
I don't know. I'm not sure yet.
Well, does anything stands out in y'all's mind about Tabor?
What?
Anything that really stands out in your mind that happened at Mount Tabor?
Oh, no, I can remember.
It was just, Mount Tabor, and it meant something to us. Because of my mother's being here all her life, and of course her daddy, George Deason, was, all his people were members, and it just meant, it was just a family church.
See, the four families started this church 150 years ago, and one of the four families was the Deasons.
Mm-hmm. And what were the others, please?
I think Brother Marcy Wine was a Mitchell, the Mitchell family.
Vern's mother, that's Mitchell,
Sam Mitchell,
yeah,
probably.
And Henderson.
This one's Henderson.
Henderson. I can't, I have to go back
and listen
to
tape. Well, he might not say it, but I got some history from a girl that, and Nevis fell, and she had a Henderson on her. Told where they're from, North Carolina or somewhere. I mean, you know, I've got that much.
Mm-hmm. She went well back then.
Yeah, she went on, but that's what I'm doing. Well, that's about all I know to ask,
Joel.
If
I wish I could say more, I could tell you more.
Well, I know
how
you feel. I feel the same way because I can't remember.
Well,
I can't
after you wrote to us, well, I had been trying to think of things, but I didn't. I was just trying to chase back to see who maybe started the church.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, let's get a little shot of you.
Oh, that's fine.
Come on, you're
don't, I don't have any.
Go ahead.
Yeah.
You don't have any old pictures of the church, do you?
I sure did.
We're trying to find a picture of just two single doors, just like that.
before the porch was put on it. I mean,
just
that's what we want to pay.
Well, I remember that. We've got
right
the sides, but
we had to take the front.
Step
mm-hmm.
up. Yeah, I remember, but I don't have a picture of it.
It may have been in my mother's pictures and been called long before now, because I don't know all her pictures. Mm-hmm. Well, we sure thank y'all then, and appreciate your help. Now we'll have tell us whatever you remember about Mount Tabor.
Well, there's not much of it I remember. My mother and daddy come up here most of the time, but after I got big enough, I didn't come with them. But
now, who were they?
Bill Deason and Hattie Deason. And, of course, all the Deasons were a member here, like Uncle Ben and Uncle George and all them. They were all members. I don't remember many of their old preachers was here, not many of them. There was a Turley preached here, I remember him. And a good one, I believe. That's about all I remember about it.
Can you remember what years that was?
No, I sure couldn't. I was born in 1910. I was about 10 years old. It'd be about 1920. Be somewhere 20 in the early 20s, anyhow.
Remember any of the organ players, song leaders, anything back about that time?
Yeah, Lucian Powell was a song leader at that time. I don't remember before they had a piano. I don't believe they even had a piano back then at that time. But
no, didn't get a piano until the early 50s.
Yeah, that's right, sure did.
But had an organ this
time. I remember Lucian Powell leading the singing here at that time.
So you wasn't saved here then?
No, I was saved in Embry in a Methodist church, but I joined this church the following year. I'm baptized over in the blue hole.
Everybody says that.
It was a local spot, wasn't
sure
it?
Was.
Right
sure
those
was.
It's the only place I guess you had.
Yeah, about the only place I had this.
Mr. Norris said that this morning.
Yeah, about the only place the creek could go dry, but it just happened to be a big hole mm-hmm. right out of water.
That George Deason he named, wasn't that one of the original members?
George Deason, my dad's brother.
He was a starter.
He was one of the starters of it too, wasn't he?
Wasn't
he one of the starters of the
I don't know where he would be or not. Now, there might have been an older one than him that might have been a starter of it. I don't know. He used to be a Benny Deason.
Well, now, where was he originally from? I tell you.
George Deason.
Uh-huh.
He was always around in Todd County here. And,
well, his ancestors are.
Well, I guess it was up here in Todd County, is all I know. Now, my grandfather used to live on this road right here, Henry Deason.
Okay.
I remember him just a small kid, but I remember him going to spend the night with him.
Well, I've got a little sketch of history that says the Deasons originally were from the Carolinas.
Well,
you
North
really think
Carolina.
About that?
Yeah, I believe I've heard something about
North
that.
Carolina.
Yeah. They're older, real old.
Uh-huh.
See, yeah,
with the
probably was from. I believe I've heard that myself since you mentioned it.
You don't know anything about the building of the church, what's that now?
No.
See, this is the third site it's been.
Yeah,
no. They tore it down in 1908, the last time,
yeah.
And moved it, what's that now?
Yeah.
You hadn't heard anybody talk about
who done the work or anything?
When I first come to this church and remember the thing about it, it was the old Weatherbury church that out here, but it changed it into this one after. I remember about that.
Don't know whether you
did the older church used to sit a little further down the road here than it did right here?
Yeah, and then out on Tucker Ridge, the race one.
Then out here by Miss Annie Mann's.
Well, on the old Jim Deason place, I mean, just.
Yeah, that's right. Out there. Mm-hmm.
They moved in 1908 to
come here. Well, because I was born in 1910, I wouldn't have been old enough to memorize about that anyhow.
What stands out in your mind about Mount Tabor? Anything in particular?
No, I really don't. After I left here, I went to West Union, Paul Frogart.
Mm-hmm.
I was a member there several years, then went over to Pleasant View. I went from Pleasant View to Concord. I'm a member of Concord Baptist Church there off the bypass
mm-hmm.
between Greenboro.
Buddy
Crabtree. Huh?
Buddy Crabtree's your pastor.
Yeah, Buddy Crabtree's your pastor. Yeah, I told him when he came out there, when I was shaking hands with him, I told him, I said, me and my wife and all the two decent people come
folks at church. Even that guy said, you say something about it, like I did. I said,
well, we sure thank you.
Well, thank y'all.
Appreciate it.
About Mount Tabor.
How long are you going to talk?
As long as you want to. Just tell us all you know.
Any information you can give us.
I mean, back when I was a kid.
Right.
Yeah, when
right.
You were saved or further back, if you can tell us anything further back, we'd like to hear it. About your daddy, your granddaddy, or anything.
What they might remember about the old church, when it was moved, just
yeah.
Anything you can remember. Whatever comes to your mind back when you were just a little boy.
Well, I was born about 3 miles from here on a farm. My daddy had a farm out there, and we worked on the farm, and one of the things he did, he had a little piece of land on the side. He said I could put that in tobacco, and I'd get what I got. So when I cut the tobacco, I think he gave me $75 for the crop, just a little bit, though, and We had a farm down there, and one thing I remember about the house, it was customary to have a well and a bucket and a rope, and you draw the water out, and we had a plum tree and all, and I'm a historian, and I like history, and I have a rock out of the house where he lived. And I have a rock out of the house where I was born. And as I told him this morning, we came to church about 3 miles and in a wagon. Or when we got to Surrey, we came into Surrey. And my mother always rode in the back seat, my dad in the front seat. And my brother and I had a discussion, though. One of us would ride with Dad to church, and the other would ride with it coming on back. And we lived there several years, and we bought a farm out here, and we bought a farm from a high tower down in Kirtlesville. We lived down in Kirtlesville a long time, had a farm down there. And my mother was sick about a week, and she passed away. And I didn't have a doctor with about one time. And after 2 years, my dad married a lady that lived next door after 2 years, and he passed away in Hopkinsville. So, myself, I met my wife in college at Western Kentucky State College, and we were in an algebra class. And she just moved to Curtinsville, where I was living. And she didn't know me, and I didn't know her. And her dad and mother's passed away years ago. Her mother died before we married. She had a brother that taught school and coached basketball and all of that. And I met her in the algebra class in Bowling Green. She was sitting up that way, and the teacher called the class. She said, Noah Deason. She looked around, she goes, are you from Kirtlesville? Yeah. So I don't know whether it's that day or another day, I said, would you like to go to a movie? She said, well, I'd kind of like to go, but I stay at the dormitory and I have to be back at 9 o'clock. So we went ahead and college, and I went with it 2 years, and went with two other girls 2 years, and finally decided I'd rather have her. I said, would you marry me? She said, well, says, give me about 6 months. Think about it. Now the story about the church, about being saved. I was 16 years old, and I come to church, and that church about once a year. And it was on a Saturday afternoon, 1925. And I've been thinking about becoming a Christian a long time, and the devil always talked me out of it. But that day, I was standing there, and God was saying, "Now you've been talking about this long enough, I want you to do something about it." That's in my words. And he gave the invitation, I stood there, and shaking, and again, Mother Hughes always went to church, but for some reason, they didn't go that Saturday, and the devil back there said, "No, where's your daddy and mother?" Said, "You know, you don't want to go for a day. Tomorrow, Sunday, you wait till the morning so they can see you walk the aisle." I went up there, and the lady helped me. And I was such a good boy that first I didn't think I'd done anything wrong, and I realized that others in the church shouted and thanked God, you know, for everything, and I couldn't do that. So I sat there on the front beach, and the lady sat right next to me, and they had to break, but I stayed there and prayed. This lady says, "Noah, can't you accept Christ that quick?" I accepted Christ. You know what happened? I jumped up shouting. The others come back in and shouted and felt like I never felt before. And we got up the pulpit and shouted some more. I was so happy. And my pastor over in Owensboro went to church. We went out a lot and tell people how to accept Christ. He said, "Now, I'll make a suggestion. Says, if you're telling anybody how to be saved, don't mention the shouting part, what he was thinking about. They might think, you know, if I didn't shout, I wouldn't be saved." So I've always done that. Everywhere I go, I talk to people about how to accept Christ. And as I said, when I was saved, they didn't have any place to baptize here in the church. We went to a creek way out here, about 3 or 4 miles, an abandoned water in the river called a Blue Hole. That's where I was baptized. And as I said this morning, went up behind a tree and changed clothes.
Who baptized you?
I forget what his name is now. This is all 1925, 60-some years. But, I really enjoyed it. I've tried to tell everybody else. I remember asking somebody that accepted Christ before I did. I said, "How will you know when you're saved?" He didn't explain it to me. He said, "You'll know." That's all he said. And, I don't know why. I've got thousands of pictures. I got 2,000 slides, and why I didn't make more pictures, you know, of this, but most of these are made after I left here. And I did send Elwood pictures I had made with the old church on the side, and the picture of the schoolhouse, and my students out there. And I remember one time when I made pictures of the school students, I had them stand up in the form of a T.
It's in that picture.
Huh?
It's in that picture.
Yeah. And
form of a T.
Him and that. And that picture's made on the side of the building. And I've always thought a lot of Mount Tabor, and I never thought it'd ever grow like this and be revamped and everything, you know.
That Saturday afternoon you were saved, was that during revival or was that just a regular Saturday evening service?
That was revival.
You remember who was carrying it on?
Do I know?
Who was preaching?
I believe a man, not sure, but I think his name was B-R-O-W-N-I-N-G Browning. I think he was from Russellville or somewhere over there. He came here and gave the message. And, I didn't make any excuses. I made it up. One thing beside me, I remember had an unusual sun setting and it kind of scared me. Now, suppose I die now before I say. I brought my students out here that took a break when they had revival. We bring them out here one day, and they've enrolled here. And I don't know whether the preacher asked me to pray or whether I just prayed. And while I got up there, I just shouted like everything, you know. And I don't think you could do that if you didn't know God. Feel you so full of happiness that you just... any other questions you'd like to ask?
Yes. What would you like to tell the future children about Mount Tabor? What would you like to get? What kind of advice would you give them?
Where would I be talking?
To the younger generation.
You mean in this locality?
Uh-huh.
Well, I think the first thing I tell them was the difference between having Christ and not having it. A lot of people think, you know, I'll wait one of these days till, and I'll do that, you know, sometime before I die. But people told me that, you know, they would one of these days. I don't go to church. I'm as good as somebody else. I said, I go to church to worship God and have fellowship. And I tell the children, they think maybe they have to give something up, but the best thing, they're taking on God. And God is the best friend they can ever have.
Don't remember anything else you
want to
tell us?
Well, I might tell them a little of this story, you know, that you're not supposed to cut it off too long, because you never know if the day you're alive and you don't know what you'll be tomorrow. And one of the main things is having a fellowship with God. God understands you, and He can give you more blessings than anybody else. Don't even have a chance to.
Well,
don't put it off or get it in your life.